You use the Configuration Wizard to configure the Financial Consolidation and Close business process. The wizard guides you through the process of defining time periods, selecting currency options, and configuring features such as journals and custom dimensions. To begin configuration, log in to Enterprise Performance Management Cloud as a service administrator and select Financial Consolidation and Close. Then select Create a New Application. Enter a name of up to 8 characters and a description. You can select a 12-period or 13-period calendar. I'll change the start year and have the fiscal year start in July. The calendar includes summary time periods for quarters and years. You can optionally include summary time periods for half years. You must select a default currency. If you require currency translations, select multi-currency. The consolidation module is enabled by default. You can disable consolidation if you want to use the Task Manager module only. You can choose between 3 balance sheet hierarchy options for the chart of accounts. The traditional and net asset options provide seated balance sheet and income statement account hierarchies. The income statement hierarchy is located under the retained earnings current member in the balance sheet. The top level roll-up for the traditional balance sheet approach is total balance sheet equals total assets minus total liabilities and equity. The top level roll-up for the net asset approach is net assets equals total assets minus total liabilities, and then total balance sheet equals net assets minus total equity. For both the traditional and net asset approach, seated members are provided in the movement dimension for tracking movements and cash flow, and seated data forms are provided for balance sheet, income statement, and cash flow. If you select the basic option, the account and movement dimensions include the seated members required for system calculations only, enabling you to define your own balance sheet and income statement hierarchies. By default, the basic option does not include a cash flow hierarchy. You can select Indirect Cash Flow to add the members to the account and movement dimensions required for the cash flow hierarchy. Seated data forms are provided for data status and exchange rates only. I'll select the traditional balance sheet approach. Enable Multi-GAAP if you need to report using multiple GAAP standards. Select Manual Adjustments if you want to load local GAAP balances, and then enter or load adjustments to calculate balances for the alternative reporting standard. Select Calculated Adjustments if you want to load balances for both local GAAP and an alternative reporting standard, and have the system calculate adjustment amounts. IFRS is the default alternative standard. In the Journal options, select Yes with Workflow to require that all journals be submitted for approval before being posted, or Yes without Workflow if approvals are not required. Enabling Intercompany Data adds an Intercompany Partner dimension for eliminating intercompany data. Select with Tracking to track elimination data in a separate member in the data source dimension. The Intercompany Entities Aggregation option determines how intercompany data is aggregated to the intercompany top member in the intercompany dimension. You can select Addition, Subtraction, or Ignore for the aggregation operator. If you select Ignore, only data for the no intercompany member aggregates to intercompany top. For multi-currency applications, you can place the Cumulative Translation Adjustment account under the balance sheet or under comprehensive income. Balance sheet is typical for US GAAP and comprehensive income for IFRS. You can add predefined calculations for key financial ratios to the account dimension. Select the groups of ratios you want to include. Note that the ratios for days sales included in the asset management ratio group can have a significant impact on performance. Ownership management allows you to perform advanced consolidations with complex ownership structures. You can enable the ownership management feature only if you have enabled intercompany data with tracking. If you enable ownership management, you can optionally enable equity pickup or partner elimination. The equity pickup option adds dimension members and business rules to calculate period-to-period equity pickup for holding companies. The partner elimination option enables you to create configurable consolidation and configurable calculation rules that write data directly to a sibling if the sibling is an intercompany partner of the entity currently being consolidated, or if a descendant of the sibling is its intercompany partner. Custom dimensions store additional detail for analysis. You can add up to 4 custom dimensions, or 3 if multigap is enabled. The data source dimension includes members to track data imported using data management, input through journals, or posted from the supplemental data module. Include another data member if you want to track data loaded using other data import tools. The translated currency input option adds the FCCS_translated_currency_input member to the consolidation dimension and enables you to enter journal data in translated values rather than local currency values. Select parent input to add the FCCS_parent_input member to the consolidation dimension, which allows you to input data to a parent-child combination in the currency of the parent. Select contribution input to add the FCCS_contribution_input member to the consolidation dimension. This allows you to input contribution level data. Contribution level data is data after elimination and proportionalization and is in the parent currency. The supplemental data module helps you organize and manage collection of supplemental data, such as footnotes, disclosures, and supporting details. You can review your selections before proceeding. If you want to enable additional features after the initial creation of the application, use the Enable Features button on the configuration page. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.